Today in Teen Talk, the number of obese children and teens in the United States is startling. So we spoke to four local students in the Prescott Library at the Wheeler School so they could weigh in on healthy habits in school. Now I want to talk about, you know, health and exercise, but also how it's linked to school. So everything from, I mean, school lunches, and do you feel like you guys lead like a healthy lifestyle?
My school in particular has a three-sport requirement, so you're required to participate in some way, either competitive or intramural, so you're always active and being in a community after hours, which is good.
For me, I think they just stepped up on gym class, like mandatory running, you're doing, make sure everybody sweats at times, and lunch got better, we have a salad bar.
Okay.
Yeah, that's probably like the best thing.
Do you think it's important for kids to be healthy, especially now? I mean, how do you fit? You're active. You dance, right?
Yeah, like we actually did like this thing last year. I remember we had to do a project on like eating disorders and everything and how it's common for dancers, being a dancer at my art school, how it's difficult. And like you could tell that it's like a lot of dancers do that, and it's just you have to get over the fact that yeah, school food might be more fattening than a lot of other food, but I mean, you have to eat. And it's hard for dancers to do that because you want to be on stage and you want to look good, but you know, you have to be healthy because if you're not healthy, you can't dance. Mm-hmm. So that's the biggest thing for like dancers at my school or dancers in general. We just have to stay healthy, and if we're not healthy, we can't dance.
Yeah.
It's good.
Yeah, my school, there's an athletic requirement at the very least for each semester or each part of the year, like winter, spring, fall. I play three different sports, but also if you don't want to play a sport, you can work out in the weight room or do some kind of outside school contract, mm-hmm. be it, I don't know, maybe tennis outside of school, something.
Yeah.
But also our school's been recently, the Wheeler School has been doing a lot of healthy options with food, and they'll say like, this is healthy, and there's a daily salad bar. Mm-hmm. And I think diet is almost, or just as, if not more important than the amount of exercise you do, because
mm-hmm.
There's just so much involved in what you need to get into your body.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Our school newly introduced a stoplight system, so the fattening foods get a little red sticker next to it, and you're encouraged to eat it, but they kind of teach you proportions and what you should be focusing on filling your plate with.
There's a whole gray area, or rather yellow area, that's like, wait, should I? Maybe I shouldn't. And then there's green for go.
Nice.
Our school went wheat on us. Everything's wheat.
Oh, everything's wheat.
Pizza,
yep.
Bread, everything.
So it seems like, I mean, do you feel like, you know, weight and exercise, do you see that as an issue in your school? Do you see some kids that are just, like, completely unhealthy? Like, do you think it's important that your schools are making?
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I think the education behind it is especially important because, I mean, mm-hmm. we're adolescents, so we can digest a lot of stuff pretty well, and it's not going to make that much of a difference. But as we get older, it's important that we know what we should be eating and what we should be doing, and that we should be exercising, and it starts in school.
Now all the teens stress the importance of eating healthy and having healthy choices at their schools. We will be hearing from the teens every day this week, and to read their bios, go to WPRI.com.